Thank you. Very good, very good. Thank you so much. So, I want to say really that your playing is so solid. It's very secure, and from a technical standpoint, you really own the piece. You're very much in control, in command of the piece. So, you're very, very sure about it, and this is good. You're playing days, so you can be sure about that. If there is something that I would like to explore with you in the piece, it's certain subtleties about color, about mood, because this is a very complex piece of Chopin. You know, he wrote this in his later period, a few years before he died. And so this is like a piece of this maturity where we have really such complexity in the harmonic language. It's like almost a meditation on the Polonaise. That's why it calls it fantasy. It's more of a fantasy on the Polonaise, actually. So the form is very complex, and also the sonority that we need to find the piano is very, very difficult, because we have to be able to create such abstract, colors and nuances. But I want to right away show you certain things about the opening. Now, the very opening. See, there are so many different colors already. So it starts a little bit more. You can create more, also by using the left pedal. You can have different sound textures, nuances. So and the. If this could sound a little bit more improvised, as if you are composing it, not Chopin, but you sit at the piano, you start like exploring something. It should sound a little bit maybe less structured, especially all this figuration here, a little more soft also, or more mysterious. Can you try? Especially something loud, that you pedal first. So first you pedal, because you see, if you pedal, the dampers are already up. So by the time you play, the piano is already, if you pedal after, the sound is not as resonant and colorful. Texture. It's just a suggestion, but you don't matter. different density. So Because they are not, it's pianissimo, yes, but they cannot be the same color. Maybe this a little bit brighter, perhaps. Something very special. And by the way, Chopin did not write the arpeggio here. Yeah, this is not Chopin. It's maybe Mr. Paderewski. But not Chopin. In the autograph, there is no arpeggio. And I play. It's actually more. To be more mysterious. But okay. Of course, another thing I want to say is that she has to play this in concert soon. So not to think of trying these things for the concert, but after the concert. Yes, so for the concert, she just has to play as she knows it. Yeah, so this is very important. Don't change things on Thursday or Friday. When you are back in Korea, then you can think about it. Okay. So, but this is a little bit more on the top. It's nice that sometimes you do take a little bit of time as you approach the end of this progression, but I wouldn't do it always because for me, if you take too much, if you slow down too much, it takes away from the rest. You see, it can be also very nice if you don't take too much time. Let's say. Which is not a da-ram or a
moan and cry.
Yeah,
yeah. So not to
thank you.
You see, when you see the, okay, this is very difficult to translate. When you see the terping in Chopin, it does not mean crescendo. It means time. It's like about time. In fact, he writes crescendo. So this is really like telling us rubato. And then the word crescendo means, okay, open up. So in most of romantic music, this is really about rubato, it's direction, yes. So let's try a little bit. Still, it's a polonaise, but here, I think after this beautiful
well, like a very an expression of sadness and almost like when something is in your head, you cannot, you know. Yeah, so this is
thank you.
there's always a reason. The second time is always, not always, but mostly. It's a little bit more. Do, re, fa, mi, re, do, re, fa, mi, re, do, re, re. And then, of course, this dissolves. So, try. Your playing is excellent. Something that in the early Polonaise you don't have, but this all the music written in the late period, the Barcarolle, the Polonaise Fantasy, even the Berceuse or the B minor Sonata, they are really so much more gigantic in terms of the contrapuntal writing. But yes, it's very beautiful later, and you can also consider bringing out a bit this beautiful left hand, would be wonderful.
Everything else you play wonderfully well.
Yeah, maybe we should take a look at this poco più lento section, which is like, you know, we are in a church. It's like a church chorale, you know, like something that a choir would sing very quietly. Legatissimo. So searching for something.
Thank you.
you know, if you want to try something, or otherwise just think. But these are really things you can make more beautiful. This transition to the D sharp minor. This, I think, is really the point where your listener should have tears. Then it's good. It means you're playing well. Would you like to try?
Thank you.
longer time. Ram, bam, 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 bam. Like there is no hope. But then the hope comes. Who said that about this ending? that he doesn't know anything that can give more uplifting joy to this piece than this ending. Can you please help me? Yes, so this has to be like, we go from the moment of totally no hope. Thank you so much. It was such a pleasure to hear you play and to work on this piece with you, which is, you know, it's a very dear piece to me. Thank you.